that GMAW process as we are in the continuation, and that we basically following the various topics regarding this GMAW understanding, and in this we gone through the GMAW safety, and then we talked about these safety gears that is followed by some kind of processes, after some processes like this, and then after it is following basically the standard to perform this kind of a weld, and these safety measures can be taken care because of these kind of things like foams, gases, electric shock, arc rays, and etc. These are the things that mean to be safety, and then after the kind of a gas cylinder, the special required safety precautions, and the cylinder must be, as we discussed, the secured in an upright position, and the cylinder should be located in an area away from the arc, that is the welding, cutting, heat, spark, and the flame, that basically leading to the safety of the particular object relating to the work, and that is according to the ANSI Z 491.1, that is the arc welding safety. So this the safety precautions that we need to taking care and to be measured. And now further, if we are going to talk about this GMAW process, so this GMAW process is carrying the various kind of equipments like your welding gun, cylinder, and the shielding gas, etc., that is to be transformed from this particular GMAW equipment. And during this GMAW process, a solid metal wire is fed through a welding gun, and that become a filler welding filler material, and shielding gas is to be used to protect the atmosphere. So that is the designing of the nozzle. That nozzle is basically carrying the electrode wire and the flow of the gas, that inert gases as well, and that is utilizing for triggering the wire electrode, and to be the electrical circuit, that is to be also the shielding gas. So these we earlier talked, and we also talked about this particular how this GMAW gun is properly well work, and how it protects it from the particular kind of working environment. So moving towards this, as we now we are going to discuss about this kind of they are electrodes, as you are familiar with these kind of electrodes that is utilizing for GMAW, and this is the metal wire that is fed through the gun by the wire feeder, as you can, as you saw here, that is, and this particular figure is having the feeder that is situated, and that can be measured by its diameter, and this is the particular GMAW electrode that are commonly packed in on the spool and the reels and the coil ranging from 1 lb to 1000 lbs. So this is the copper coated or the copper coated material that leading to the welding. As you can see, it is in the reel form. That means the continuation of the welding is not hampered, and as we do not try to change the electrode as well. So these electrode having their another kind of importance regarding the working, as we talked earlier also, that this particular process of GMAW is also included in the robotics welding. So that robotics is nothing, just providing a method for the continuation of the welding. So these electrode wire is very much important. Now the electric arc, as we are all know about this electric arc, in that we earlier lecture as well, that the arc welding is basically relating to these kind of arcs that helps to protect the that help to do the welding in a very finer way, and that is leading to the a very continuous welding. And this is the arc occur in the gas field, that is space between the electrode wire and the workpiece, that is the arc, and it is having the temperature range above 10,000 Fahrenheit. So this is the as the wire electrode and the particular workpiece is heated up and melt, they form a pool of molten material that called a weld puddle, as we discussed in the weld puddle. As you can see, this is the very fine kind of a picture that is showing over here of the weld pool, and you can see here the this 0.45 inch ER706S6 at 400 rpm wire feeding speed and a 28.5 volt with a 90% argon, 10% CO2 shielding gas. So that is the scenario of the MIG welding that is showing into this figure. That is the picture which is taken during the welding process. So that is the wire feeding with the argon and the combination of the shielding gas, that is CO2 again. So these all are the gases that producing the kind of a weld. As you can see, this is the fine bed of the weld is locating over here. So this is what the welder watches and manipulate while welding. So these are can be manipulated according to that. Now if we talk about this particular shielding gas, so these shielding gas are having a kind of a protecting tendency to protect the particular weld specimen, and it also help to provide the shielding gas, usually carbon dioxide, argon, or the mixture of the both, due to maintaining the kind of we can say that the kind of economy. So to maintain the economy, we mix these both argon and the carbon dioxide gas to minimize the spend. You can see the gauge on the regulator that is showing the gas flow rate and the bottle pressure, as nowadays we are much familiar with this kind of a cylinder, but this is the cylinder of the argon. And now this the an aluminium welding done with the GMAW process. As you can see, the fine bed that is showing with the aligned side of the HZ as well. So this welder lays a bed of molten metal that quickly solidified into a weld, and the resulting welder is a kind of a slag free. So this has to be understand, that is the solidified weld metal. As you can see here, application that is the next application activity that we discuss in this, and this is the equipment setup, how we are going to perform this welding. As you can see, there is a extra setup that is located in this GMAW process, as in comparison with the SMAW process, that the connect work clamp, the select the electrode, that is the setup of the GMAW process, and the type of the electrode, the diameter, the shielding gas, select the shielding gas, then turn on the power supply on, and then adjust the machining output like a wire feed and the voltage, and adjust the gas flow rate as well. So before proceeding for the welding, we need to perform this kind of setup, and the selection of the from the clamping to the work, and the selection of the electrode and selecting the shielding gas is the very important role to play when performing this kind of a welding. So these things is to be considering. As you can see now, this shielding gas is also providing. So this is the another kind of effect that can be measured. And to maintain the economy, we need to take care of the flow of this shielding gas as well. So one of the another parameter added into this process as well, and that the wire feed and the voltage parameter is to be considered that earlier as well. So these are the variables that we are talking about, the welding variable, that the wire feed speed and the voltage that providing a kind of a specific weld to protect the layer. And this is the operation control variable, that is the travel guide, gun angle, contact tip to work distance, and the gas flow rate. So this is the basic we are talking about the work feed speed and the amperage relation. So the flow of the metal and the, as you can say, the melting of the wire leading to these relation with the voltage or the amperage. So that also provide a kind of synchronization. It required the kind of a synchronization between the heat input and the wire feed rate, because if we provide a normal rate and increase the current, so what will happen, the rate of flow, the rate of melting will increase and the wire feeding will be slow. That will leading to the lack of the welding. Or if we put the wire feeding rate higher and the welding is low, that is also leading to the improper welding portions. So for avoiding this, we need to maintain this kind of a variable for the sound and clean welding. So again, what kind of things that needs to be taking care, that the striking an arc, making a weld, how to generate some of the common conditions that we discussed. As you can see there in the figure, the upper head where welding is to be doing, and the position the gun the over the joint, position the face seal to protect eye and face, pull the gun trigger and begin the welding. So these particular is to be taking care. And these arc striking is nominal in this particular system to generate. It is not like the stick welding. And you can see the laying of the bed that maintain the contact tip to the workpiece, CTWD, that is 3x8 to 1x2, and use a uniform travel speed. That is the most importantly watching the puddle. As you can see, this is the contact tip and the wire electrode. That is also the consideration as well. ऐसा ना हो कि हम welding कर रहे हैं और weld puddle जो है एकदम to जो nozzle है contact tip है उसके पास में आ जाए, तो ऐसा chances हो सकता है कि या तो वो जो electrode holder है वो चपक जाए, या फिर welding जो है वो उसमें वो पिघल के निकल जाए. या बना के रखना होता है. सो द अपियरेंस ऑफ द पडल एंड द रिच वेयर द मोल्टन मेटल सॉलिडिफाई इंडिकेट द करेक्ट ट्रेवल स्पीड, एंड द रिच शुड बी अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 3x8 10 mm बिहाइंड द वायर इलेक्ट्रोड. एंड द मोस्ट बिगनर टेंड टू वेल्ड टू फास्ट, रिजल्टिंग इन अ रोपरी बेड विद द मीन्स ऑफ स्लो डाउन. एंड this is the fill the crater. As we know about the, we talked about these kind of cracks, that the kind of a problem when the welding is completed by these particular passes. So what we need to do is to fill the crater by pausing or using a straight back step, releasing the gun trigger and pull gun away from the work after the arc goes out. How that we need to maintain these particular cracks, and the large crater can cause the weld cracking as well. So that is need to be avoid. Then the how the crater is related, then the restarting the weld bead by backing step into the last weld crater, as we discussed the in the crater portion, and then the continue moving forward. And this technique should be in a seamless transition from one weld to the next weld. So as you saw in the particular GMAW welding weld bead, so that weld bead basically provided by the kind of the transition from one box to next one. Now the mode of the metal transfer from this particular GMAW process, that is the process that features several distinctive individual method and types of metal transfer, and the mode of metal transfer variables like voltage, ampere, shielding gas, and by changing one or more variable you can go from one metal transfer mode to another. There are the two common methods, that is the conventional mode of the metal transfer, that is the short arc and the axial spray. As you can see the weld bead of this particular, how we create a kind of a weld, that the application, joint design, base material thickness and the property determine the appropriate mode to use, that the basic conditions that need to be taken care. As you can see the typical axial spray are applicable on this particular fillet joint, and that is the mode of transfer that is providing into that is this particular arc transfer is in the droplet form, and this short arc transfer that is showing that the in short arc transfer, the arc is initiated and droplet is formed on the end of the wire, and the wire touches the workpiece and produces a kind of a short circuited, and then the droplet is then transferred to the weld puddle. So these are the short arc transformation, that the arc is initiated and a droplet is to be formed on the end of the wire. So that is the process of this particular melting of this particular system. So the wire touches the workpiece and produces a short circuit. The droplet is then transferred to the weld puddle as well, and that is how it transformation take place. And if we are talking about this, as you can see the gun which is showing is at is some on an angle, so that axial spray arc transfer is on the very high current that is to be used when we are performing this kind of axial. As you can see there is a tilting in the particular electrode gun, and that requires the very high current that has to be used. A point form at the end of the electrode and the fine droplets. The puddle is very fluid, making out of the position welding is difficult. So jo puddle hota hai, jo particular liquid material create hota hai iske andar, usko that is very floody, and floody means bahut easily wo apne position se deflect ho sakta hai. So to maintaining this, the arc transfer is to be maintained. So now we are moving toward this about the troubleshooting of the weld, that is what is our goal to make a good weld, and what are the these things that is to be eliminate the ropeway convex bed, and to excessive remove the eliminate the excessive spatter, and eliminate the porosity. So these are the troubleshooting the weld, that the goal is to avoid this kind of provide a good welding. This GMAW would be maintained by only by the maintaining the kind of a parameters in a very appropriate manner, that is the different distance between the electrode gun and the workpiece, the travel speed, the voltage and arc concentration, the shielding gas. So these all are combining and create a kind of a special this weld, to create this weld special. So that the troubleshooting to be maintained, and then further the moving toward the advantages of the GMAW, that is it is a kind of a high operating factor, and as you can see where it is located to weld the particular car chassis, and that is that the kind of a weld is happening over there, and this high operating factor, easy to learn, limited cleanup, and the use of many different metals, that is the stainless steel, is to be taken care, and it uses in all positions, like a grate from the home uses, that is 1105V and 203 voltage units can be used. The limitations is the less portable than the shotgun length is 15 foot guns. The GMAW equipment is more expensive than the SMAW equipment, as it included the welding gun and your we can say the shielding gas. Right, so the external shielding gas can be blow away by the wind as well, and the high radiant energy, radiated energy is to be heated, and it is difficult to use in or out welding position as well. So these are the limitations and the advantages that we discussed. So according to the AWS, there are the coding for the electrode, for the GMAW electrode, that the coding is the E is defining by the electrode positioning, that is the rod, it is in the rod. 70 is the providing the 70,000 psi minimum tensile strength of that particular electrode wire. S is the solid, X is providing the kind of chemicals or the compositions with the other kind of materials. So these are the basic coding of the electrode that is to be weld before selecting the welding operation, and which kind of a weld is to be performed on the. So this is the just a lesson plan that we discussed. So these are the coding that are very helpful to understand and select the material for performing the weld. So that the thing that we need to understand all the time, and due to this selection of the weld electrode, we can perform a very good and better welding, and as compared to the other one. So that is the brief introduction of GMAW process, and in further we will discussing one by one the important parts of this particular test to understand.